this is Julia, and today I'm going to be preparing an apple skillet cake with rosemary crumble. For this recipe, you will need one cup of all-purpose flour, a half a cup of brown sugar, one-fourth teaspoon of salt, 4 tablespoons of unsalted butter room temperature, and 1 tablespoon of roughly chopped rosemary. So this is for the crumble. And so to make the... Okay, let's start. Okay, so you take your brown sugar. Oops. Be careful. Your flour. See, I am not an expertise. Rosemary, your salt, and your butter. Oops. Okay. Make sure that to be careful if you don't have any grown-ups around the food processor. And then pulse. You don't want it to pulse. Okay, pulse. Pulse the ingredients until it clumps up. Do it. Do it, Julia.
I think I did it too much.
Stop it, stop!
That was a teeth. Yes.
Stop! Okay, as you can see, this is probably the right texture.
I'm back. And so the crumble is resting in the fridge, and now we have to make the cake. So for the cake, you will need unsalted butter, one-third of a cup of unsalted butter, room temperature, 1 large apple cored, peeled, and cut into cubes, baking soda, salt, a half a teaspoon of salt, 1 cup of brown sugar, a cup of milk, 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract, 2 eggs, and one cup and 3/4 of flour. Okay, so let's start. So you're gonna take your butter and your sugar. You're gonna take your butter, take your,
so we need to
take your unsalted butter. Okay, this is. And cream it with your sugar. And you're gonna take and make sure the mixture is locked, because you don't want to just like, you want to be safe. Mix this until it is like nice and fluffy. So butter and sugar is mixed together. You want to scrape the sides down and then add in your eggs one at a time. And add in one egg and make sure it's stirred in well, and then add the other. Mixed in, you want to keep alternating with your milk and your flour, and keep alternating. So you put a little milk and then a flour and the milk and then flour and the milk until everything is mixed in. Okay, so after you mixed everything together, you have to put in your salt and your baking soda with your apples. And you gotta fold them in, mix them together, all that good stuff. Now, let's do it. Okay, that's enough torture for the apples. This is what it's supposed to look like. And then, put it in your pan. So guys, this is what it's supposed to look like after you put the batter in the pan before you put the crumble on top. It's not supposed to go all the way, because then there would be no space.
Okay.
So you add your crumble in now. I hope this is what it's supposed to look like. Okay, so it doesn't have to be perfect, because we're all humans and we ain't no master chef. If you're looking on this on YouTube, I ain't no master chef. I'll tell you that for sure. Hey guys, after several hours of making this cake, I succeeded! Now, enjoy.